In this video, we will introduce the Medit Design app. Medit Design is a new name for an upgraded and improved version of our Medit Compare app. With the new name also comes a wider variety of features, such as Duplicate, Offset, Thicken, Boolean, and others. If you still don't have Medit Design, go to the App box and install the latest version of the app. To run the app, create a new case and click the Medit Design icon on the top. In the new dialog window, you will be asked to import scan data for Medit Link. You can also import data saved outside of Medit Link. To do this, first click Cancel and then find the Import Local Files icon at the bottom of the app window. You can also use various sample data provided by Medit in the app welcome package. Imported 3D data will be listed in the data tree on the left and color-coded for easy management. If you want the data to be displayed in single colors, use monochrome option from the Change Data Display Mode on the right. In the side toolbar, you will also find different axis view options for easy rotation and examination of the data. You can hide or show data by clicking its color icon on the data tree, or adjust data transparency by moving the slider. Now that the data is prepared for work, let's take a look at the modes available in the app. First up is the alignment mode. If you have to compare data, you can first align it in this mode. Choose manual alignment to select the matching points yourself, or automatic alignment to align data without any defined points. Next is the deviation display mode. For this mode, you will be asked to assign reference and target data. Refer to the deviation color bar to analyze previously aligned data. Turn on color map at the bottom and move your mouse along the data to see the exact measurements. You can create an annotation with the exact deviation measurement result by clicking on the data. To delete the results, select Delete Measurement Results at the bottom and click on the annotation. Use the Create Sections tool to draw the lines and check selected section and details. To measure the section line, go to Measurement Mode. Use this mode to select points on the data and measure the distance between them. You can do measurements based on 1, 2, or 3 points on the line. You can also take measurements of the angles. And the length of the section line. Or calculate the area of the section line. Select Delete Measurement Results at the bottom and click on the annotations you want to erase. Now let's look at the Roughness Measurement mode. Refer to the color bar to analyze the roughness of the target data. The green color indicates smooth surface data. Use this mode to check the surface roughness of the prepared teeth. Adjust the resolution of the color bar to get more detailed information. Another mode that you can find on the top is the curvature display mode. This mode will help you analyze the relief of the surface. The color red shows areas that are embossed, and blue areas that are engraved. In other words, the red areas will raise in relief from a surface, and blue areas will have a shallow depth. Here you should check the depth of the margin line or look for any areas that are engraved too deep. Now let's look at the transformation mode. In this mode, you can transform data along the axis or modify its size. First, select the data you want to change. The data selected for transformation will be outlined. Let's go over the transformation tools listed at the bottom. Click the first icon to translate or rotate data by entering the desired value for the X, Y, or Z axes. Use the Apply button to save changes. Note that the changes will be applied to data across all modes. The changes won't be saved if you don't press Apply. Use the Scale tool to set values for the X, Y, and Z axes and make changes to the size. Check the Uniform box to use the same value across all axes and simultaneously scale the data. The next tool is the Transformation Matrix. Use it to convert the data by manually setting values for each individual element. 3D Manipulator allows easy scale, translation, and rotation of the model by utilizing the manipulator with your mouse. And the last mode that we are going to look at is the Edit mode. We provide a wide variety of tools that can be used to view, trim, and edit data. Use the Reverse Data tool to turn the data surface inside out. If you need to remove certain parts of the data, use various selection options available under the Trimming tool. Let's look at some of these selection options. The first one is Smart Teeth Selection. Use this option to automatically select all teeth and leave out the gingiva. Note that this function is available only if the data was acquired by Medit Scan for clinics. Smart selection can be done on all teeth of the arch or on a single tooth. The next selection option is the flood fill selection. It fills and selects the area that is clicked and dragged over. You can move the mouse to expand or reduce the selection area. If you have missed some small areas when working with a polyline or brush selection, they can be automatically filled in. For this, turn on the autofill selected area. Or you can use invert selected area and delete those parts. If there are holes in your scan data, go to the Edit mode and fill them up using the Fill Holes tool at the bottom. Click the Sculpting tool to manually modify the scan data. Use the Sculpting toolbox on the right to add, remove, smoothen out, or morph the data. Here you can also adjust the brush strength and size. Now let's focus on the newly added features of this app. With the help of this function, splint creation will be fast and easy. If you want to learn how to create a splint in this app, please watch our Create a Splint with Medit Design video. One of the new features is the offset that allows you to create an offset. You can change offset direction to either inside or outside. To do this, click on the inside-outside icon next to the slider. New data will appear in the data tree. Another new feature is Thicken that increases the thickness of the selected mesh. Use this feature to create various appliances like splints, whitening trays, and surgical guides. Click the icon next to the slider to change the thickness direction of the mesh to either outside, inside, or both sides. Remember to click Apply to save your changes. Next, we will talk about the Boolean feature. With this tool, you can combine, remove, or extract the intersecting mesh data. Click the Union option to combine two or more meshes into one. Use this option when handles or other attached data has to be added to the model. Use Intersection to leave only the common parts of the two mesh data. By using the Cut option, you will remove the overlapping B data from the A data. Use the latter to delete the bite from the splint model. The next new feature is Duplicate. Use this tool to duplicate only the selected area and create a separate data file for it. Blockout Undercut is another new tool in the app. You can adjust the Blockout Undercut according to the insertion direction. The blue arrow shows the insertion direction. To set the insertion direction to face toward you, adjust the data position and press Set Arrow to your viewpoint. The undercut will change accordingly to the modified path of insertion. Click Apply to see the result. Surface smoothness can be adjusted with the Smooth Surface tool from the bottom toolbar. Select the surface area, adjust the smoothness strength using the slider, and click Apply. When you're all set, click Complete to save the data. In the new dialog window, you will have three options. Choose Overwrite if you want to replace the existing file with a new one. Choose Export to save the changes as a separate file. This option allows you to keep both the pre-existing and a new file. If you click Advanced Options in a new dialog window, you can make separate decisions on each file from the data tree.